The procedure when we have parents and the infants come into our practice, first of all, they fill out a two-page evaluation form, and it asks specific questions just like the things that Aaron was going over. You know, do you have, you know, these types of problems going on? Is the baby having trouble with feeding? You know, does the mom, what are the things that are going on with her as well? After that, again, we take initial photos of the lip and the tongue to be able to see what type of tie that they have with the frenum, with the muscle attachment. The assistants usually are talking to them and preparing them with what to expect for the procedure immediately after, and then the healing time, the two-week post-op healing time. I come in and generally, you know, I'll ask or answer, excuse me, any other questions that they have, but right after that, once they are clear on, you know, what the diagnosis is, they've already usually seen like some videos or some testimonials or you know, they've talked, coming from a lactation consultant referral a lot of times, so they have an understanding of what the procedure is. Specifically, we use a laser, and it is absolutely hands down the best way to do a procedure like this for infants or for children or for adults. The laser energy is very biocompatible with the body. It doesn't create a lot of inflammation. The reason that you, myself, or any of us would have discomfort after a procedure is done is an inflammation response that the body has produces. And so the other thing that we do not do any anesthesia or numbing. It's just simply not necessary with the laser. The amount of time that we can go in and be very precise with the laser, with the release, you know, the child cries because we're in their mouth, just like when I try to take a picture in their mouth. So the procedure can be done at the practice, and then we allow the mom, parents to come back, and then they actually get to feed. So I've mentioned that we don't do any anesthesia. One of the best things for the baby is to really get back to trying to feed right after the procedure is done. When they have something done in their mouth, they can develop an oral aversion, and basically that's just like, hey, you just did something that I didn't like in my mouth, and I'm gonna shun away from trying to, you know, have anything else done with my mouth. So we really encourage feeding right after the procedure's done. We talk about the stretches too. The stretches need to start, you know, the same day of the procedure. We make sure that they follow through with those. The stretches are done in order to make sure that the muscle attachment doesn't grow back. I've been doing laser dentistry since 2010, and so I have learned that with adult patients, and you know, part of my technique that I use now is just some stuff that I learned from past challenges that I had and corrections that I had to go back in and make, but also with additional trainings that I've done over the years. And so you know, we have really good success with that procedure.